This is Lewis Hart for Boxing Social in association with Empire Fight Store Forged Irish Stout. Delighted to be joined with Stephen Smith, victorious 10 rounds both for Charlie Edwards today. Happy with what you saw out there from, I suppose, the comeback of Charlie Edwards?
Yeah, listen, very proud of him. He's been through a lot, not just in the build-up to this fight, but of late, you know, last 12 months, 18 months, he's been through a hell of a lot. Being kept out the ring through, you know, problems outside of boxing and politics, which is shite in my opinion. I don't like hearing or seeing anyone who's not able to box, especially someone who's dedicated to himself, lives in the gym, you know, really lives the life. So when I met up with him and, you know, I gave him my word, I'm all in on it with the coaching with him. I just want him to get, you know, speak to the right people, get the opportunities and get the chance to, you know, to perform and to do it with the showcase like tonight, you know, on Channel 5 and, you know, on a bill top by himself. It was amazing for him, and it was one of them. I said to him before the fight, it was a bit of a no-lose situation tonight. He could go in and blow him away and everyone likes it, take notice, or he could go in and get round under his belt, which he hasn't had. So he got 10 good rounds tonight with a quality operator, the former European champion. So I'm really happy, and he ticked a lot of boxes for me.
Was the most important thing there for Charlie almost to sort of make that walk to the ring, get the cobwebs off, like more, would you think it was the mental hurdles in a sense from I suppose all maybe the trauma, you could say, that's been happening in this past couple of years?
Listen, 100% it was handling emotions. I spoke to him all week about, listen, it's going to become emotional, he's going to get emotions beforehand, he's going to get emotions during, and he get emotions afterwards. He's got to control it, and you know, he's done that ring walk, and I told him to enjoy that, and you know, I know he loves all that side of it, and you know, he's a showman at the end of the day, and he did, he soaked it up. But when he got in the ring, and then, you know, the MC started talking, and he had his back, like, to his opponent, he's looking sort of into his own corner. I seen the emotions filling up, and I thought, keep it together, you know, and I spoke to him and just said, look, when you start focusing on your opponent, what we've got to do, what we're working on game plan wise, it switches him back on, and you know, he controlled the emotions really well beforehand. Listen, it got to him afterwards on his interview, you know, I don't know anyone in his interview, he went a bit at the start of it, but it was just all letting it out what he's been through, you know, and he has been through a lot. So it's done now and he's back, and, you know, the future's bright.
And to now see him walking in the gym and having a smile on his face, he talks about how happy he is boxing. I suppose to be the person that instilled that back into him and be a part of that must be a good feeling for yourself as well.
Yeah, of course. Listen, I'm just happy that, you know, when we had them initial conversations, that everything I said to him was meant, and, you know, I meant every word I said, and it's now coming to fruition where I said, look, we speak to the right people and we get you back fighting in the gym again. You can go out there and perform, and all you need is the backing and all you need is the platform to go and do it. And, you know, he spoke to different promoters, and to give the silence the due, he backed him, they gave him a contract. He's got, you know, he's got regular activity coming up where he's got like 4 fights, you know, all penciled in. So Charlie Edwards getting a bit of momentum behind himself is a force for anyone.
And there about the momentum, and I suppose how important is that momentum now? Because he, as you said, he'd like to have been a bit more active these past couple of years. So now it's about, listen, we've got this fight out of the way, the cobwebs are dusted, let's roll straight through onto, you know, a fight in the summer, I'd imagine you say.
Yeah, listen, the next one's penciled in June, July. So see how the cuts are and stuff, it may be more like July now, but you know, that's up to the Saarlands. You know, as I say, they're backing him, they're on board. He got a cut last week in sparring, which was a nightmare, to be honest with you. We thought, oh, what Lamont, just bad luck to this kid needs, and to be fair to him, he was like, nah, I'm going to fight, I'll get it healed, I'll do what I've got to do. You know, he spent time in the oxygen chamber and he done everything he could to get it back healed up, and he got in tonight and beat it, you know, a class operator when he got cut. He got cut on the eye a week ago today, so that just shows you his heart and, you know, his composure, what he kept beforehand, and, you know, how much of the desire he's got, and he went let knock him out the ring tonight. And, you know, when he in the build-up, when it happened, it was easy to think that like it was all over and it was just bad luck and he wasn't meant to be here. But he was adamant, he kept a strong mind, strong will, and he was here, and he's had his night, he's had his moment.
So did you say you got cut just before? Did you say Charlie 7 days? How did you get over that? I guess.
Hey, to be honest with you, it was his last spar. It was his second to last round, and he got an elbow in the eye, and it was just seeing his face straight away, and you'd seen the blood, and you think the worst, and you know, he got himself in. You know, he was in the oxygen chamber. He was doing everything he could to heal it up, and you know, he got in there tonight, and you know, with a cut over his eye, and he done what he could, and I think he had a good performance at the end of the day. You know, after the ring bust and good 10 rounds under his belt, and you know, he showed that he's a class act, and he's definitely going to be a threat in that bantamweight division, which is wide open in my opinion.
For sure. I suppose now you are 100% as a coach so far. You've obviously got Steed in action tomorrow. So sort of happy with how things are going?
Yeah, definitely. Listen, I've hit the ground running, so to speak. I've got a really good stable of fighters, and you know, it's a pleasure and a privilege for myself to, you know, to know that they I've got their backing, and you know, they trust in me, and that's a good thing to basically for a new coach, basically, you know, for a former world champion to say, look, will you coach me? It was a massive, massive compliment for myself, and all I wanted to do was be all in and show him that, you know what, I can back what he's putting his faith in me, and I can bring what I bring to the table, and I know I can be as good as any coach in this country, and I've just got to go and show that.
Absolutely. Stephen, thank you for taking time to speak to me. Appreciate it. Well on the win tonight. Top man. Thank you, mate. Cheers.